See ya.
.me actually went through a bid where, you know, it's actually the CCTL of the island country of Montenegro. And it went through a bid process where they were opening up second level registrations at .me, and Affilius and GoDaddy together won the bid. I think it's a lovely TLD. There's many vanity CCTLDs like .tv, .cc, .bz, .nu. But by far .me is probably the best vanity CCTLD I've seen. Well, .in I think actually has also got equivalent potential, because .in can stand for information, internet, international, etc. So I think India has got a good CCTLD also, but .me is a very interesting vanity CCTLD. They're projecting it as a domain name option for individuals and, you know, social networking sites, or social networks worldwide, or individual profile pages, etc. and things like that. So I think it has good potential. They're right now in the initial phase, so they're actually pretty, charges are pretty high. I was explaining to somebody else that typically they follow a Dutch auction model. Since the namespace is reserved, when you're launching out, a lot of generic names are available, so they charge very high. Over a period of time, they'll gradually reduce that charge. And, you know, GoDaddy has a huge, huge channel, I mean, huge marketing channel. They're 10 times the size of the next largest registrar. In terms of number of domain names they are on an ongoing basis, so they're actually going to be effectively able to capitalize the channel to market .in. ICANN was formed as an organization. Network Solutions was the whole and sole registry and registrar for .com, .net, for domain names worldwide. People around the world had an objection to the fact that the US, you know, the internet is not a US owned thing now, so why is it that a single company has monopoly on the internet namespace? That's the reason why the Internet Consortium of Assigned Names and Networks, ICANN, was formed by the US government with a specific mandate that over a period of time they need to sort of delinearize and, you know, disperse and decentralize this whole internet governance model, so to speak. And so they started off with decentralizing registrars, keeping registries unique. You know, they started decent like registrars, and you saw the impact. Your domains used to cost $100 and $70, and within 1 year of actually decentralizing registrars, it started costing $7, $8, and $10, and a massive benefit to the consumers, etc., and things like that. Another one of their mandates was to decentralize TLD registries, and they actually did two rounds of that as a test bed, which is when .info, Aero, Museum, Biz, etc. came, you know, .name and things like that. And they did two rounds of that, .mobi, .tel, etc., as experiments to figure out, if, you know, because when you're releasing a new TLD, there's a significant impact on, you know, if the TLD goes out of business, your 10,000 internet websites will die suddenly. So you have to make sure the model, you get it right. So they wanted to sort of experiment with it. They did that, and now they're sort of at the end of that mandate, where they've already got a documented process in terms of how they're going to roll this out, and so it should probably happen in the next 1 year. Where I think at least 200 companies will apply for TLD registries and then open them out. You'll see many different business models: free domain names, you know, cheap domain names, really expensive domain names for a specific community. You'll see different models, you know. Actually, I don't think so, because if Scanzo wasn't there, currently on the internet, you'd see a 404 page. And it's better to see a page containing relevant links than a 404 page. Scanzo essentially is monetizing websites that don't exist, that wouldn't go to a landing page, that would never actually show you a website. So I personally would think that content is obviously better than no content. And in that content, we and other companies like us are taking significant steps to ensure that the content is as geared and as close to what the user is looking out for as possible. So firstly, mistypes. I would still say that even there, it's got value, but mistypes are a very small percentage of the total traffic that Scanzo or any parking company receives. A lot of generics. You type cars.com and you don't see anything, right? It's better to show you a page with a bunch of interesting links and interesting sites that you can visit, as compared to not showing you anything. So a larger portion of the traffic is actually generics, people who actually build traffic on these domain names through various resources, etc., and stuff like that. So if somebody's coming out there, you might as well show them information. Even in mistypes, I would go so far as to say, I still think at the end of the day, the consumer or the customer has the choice to browse away from that site. But at any point in time, I would say information is better than no information. In any circumstance, it's not just parking. So to me, I think it's a value proposition. We're actually launching a large number of products in the communication space entirely free. So email, instant messaging, etc. They're exactly. All branded under .pw brand. .pw is actually the CCTL in the island country of Palau. And we have rights to use the CCTLE namespace for these products and services. They're right now in sort of an internal development model, so I can't really speak much about it. But
would they be targeted to India or globally?
To everybody, globally. Directa has never actually built anything specifically for just an Indian audience or just people in a specific country. It's always been a global.
That's about it. Thanks so much.